Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will build a scroll animation with stacked cards using GSAP and React. The cards will appear one by one while scrolling. Each card will show an image and text using clip path and opacity animations. These animations run only once when the card enters the screen, unless the page is refreshed. For the animation, we'll use ScrollTrigger and ScrollSmoother with the useGSAP hook. This animation is also fully responsive and works well on all screen sizes. Let's get started. In a previous tutorial, we created this project using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. I was asked to make a React version of this project. So in this video, we will rebuild the same project step by step using React. Let's first create the React project. We'll use Vite for this. Then we select a framework. And we will use JavaScript in this tutorial. Here are the commands we need to run. Just type them exactly the same way. Finally, we open the localhost link in the browser to see the project. This file is the entry point of a React project. Before starting, I added the images to the public folder. The other files are inside the source folder. Let's start with the app component. This file is very simple. It imports the stacked cards component. Then it renders it inside a div. Let's move on to creating the stacked cards. First, we install GSAP and its React plugin in the terminal. This allows us to use GSAP animations inside a React project. Then we import ScrollTrigger, ScrollSmoother, and the useGSAP hook. We also import the CSS file. This data array includes the titles, descriptions, and images. The stack cards component contains the HTML structure and animations. We use smooth wrapper and smooth content for scroll smoother. This extra div creates some space before the animations begin. Inside the container, we map through data to create all the cards. The key prop ensures each card is unique. Each card has two parts, one for the text and one for the image. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we'll build the layout, style the cards, and make everything responsive. We can use Google fonts for the titles and descriptions. The images are set to fully cover their containers. Both spacer and container take full width and 100 viewport height. We set the width to 70% so there is space on both sides. Each card takes up 75% of the viewport height. We use a shadow and background color to highlight it. We use margin to create space between the cards when scrolling. Each card consists of two parts, text and image. Each part takes 50% width and the full height. The description width is set to 80% to keep it centered and readable. The right corners of the image are not rounded, so we adjust them. We'll now add media queries to make the layout responsive. The clamp function makes the container's width responsive. We change the layout to vertical using flex direction. The image and text take the full width. We set the height of the text area to 40%. The image height is set to 60%. We also fix the corners of the image. We set the image height to 80% for mobile screens. The paragraph is hidden to save space and keep the design clean. Now let's add animations using GSAP. We'll use two references to target the wrapper and content elements. We import useRef to connect references to DOM elements. The useGSAP hook lets us run GSAP animations in React. Now we initialize smooth scrolling. The smooth value controls how soft the scroll feels. We enable effects to allow additional scroll-based animations. This helps fix flickering issues on mobile screens. Now we select all cards to add animations to each one. Before the animation, all images are hidden with clip path and transparency. The titles and descriptions are also invisible at the start. For each card, we select the image and text elements. The card scales based on its position. The scroll trigger starts a bit further down the page for each card. You can fully customize the scale and start values based on the number of cards. It is explained in detail in the JavaScript version, so you can watch that video if you like. The animation ends when the bottom of the card reaches the bottom of the screen. We use end trigger to calculate the animation's endpoint based on the full container. The card stays pinned in place while we scroll. We set pin spacing to false to avoid adding extra space below each pinned card. We also create another scroll trigger to reveal the image and text. These animations run only once unless the page is refreshed. When the card enters the screen, the image slides in with a clip path animation. The text also fades in and moves up slightly. We use stagger to delay each text element. The text animation starts 1.5 seconds before the image animation ends. Finally, we add the scope to keep the animations clean and limited to this component. And there you have it. We created a stacked card scroll animation using GSAP and React. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.